So I've been trying to figure out a way to do all the things I want to do in art, because right now I'm so busy during the day drawing pages for my comic that I can't really do anything else. Sometimes working 12 hours a day doing that type of stuff. But I was like, okay, I still kind of want to do some fan art, and I also need to do warm up, but I don't have time to do anything terribly dedicated. So yeah, I mean, unless it's my own stuff. So what I'm gonna do is I have these cards that I put on, like, ooh, it's like 250 of them or something like that, maybe a little less, maybe 200, I'm not sure. Anyway, they've all got different characters on them that I want to draw. Let's see, like Rorschach is on this one, which is blinding brightness on some of these lights. And then let's see, let's just go to random Bane. Okay, so I figure I shuffle these up every day, and I take about maybe an hour to warm up, and then draw a few of these. And that's what I'll do every day. And that'll give me the opportunity to, do a little fan art, do a little warm up, something that's not going to actually be printed in a comic book. It'll be fun. Maybe even fun to watch. So, anyway, that, if that's terrible, is my plan going forward. I'm gonna try to do this every single day. Shuffle them up and basically play roulette with who I get to draw. Nova, the space cop. So, let's see. Pull up a reference of Nova. He's a giant red star on his head. Shouldn't be too bad. Okay. Now that is pretty small. Let's zoom in a bit. Yeah, how about that? Yeah. Okay. I should probably get the shape of his head in. Out of the way stuff. Okay. So one thing I've been curious about is if this will actually take up an hour if I do three of these, four of these, five of these. Like, how many should I do to warm up? Okay. So basically, the star on his head is a compass rose. He's got these spikes that go up on his shoulders. Got weird things that glow. Okay, but the helmet, that's the important part here. Yeah, I think I like the cleaner version where he doesn't have all this crap all over him, but I'm gonna leave the spike. Helmet, pretty simple. Then flares out at the neck so he can, turn his head. Back out. Then does connect, right? Goes all the way back. Yeah. And then it's not just a star on his head, it's like a compass rose. So be like, this where it connects. Not that you could actually see out of something like this, but you know, whatever, comics. If you've seen Judge Dredd's, you'd, whew, there's no way to see out of that. And then these two actually go up at a weird angle over his eyes, like little eyebrows. Yeah. That's Nova, right? Yeah. Now, decision point about how I want to ink this. And I've thought about it. I mean, I have like a million inks and things, and then I also have, you know, brush pen, brush pen, brush pen, Tombow, Micron, Sharpie, brush pen. So I think I'm going to use a brush pen. Brush pen. Okay. Let's go with, it's my newest one. I'm going to use that one. Oh, you know what? I'll outline with Tombow. Hard to see on the monitor if I ink like I normally do. I have to keep my hand like below it so the camera can see it. I don't like doing that. Working some stuff out. Very frowny Nova. I actually at one point used to tape everything down, not even that long ago, and it made it to where I could draw from basically every angle, but I started getting away from that because I started using my iPad to do art, and I mean, you can just turn the canvas any which way you want. One of the things I wanted to do with this, because kind of not knowing what I'm drawing day to day makes me learn to draw things. Let's see if I remember how this actually connects. Here. So instead of just, you know, I know I'm going to be drawing cityscape, so, you know, I need to draw cars and light poles and all that stuff, but sometimes I might need to draw a dude in a helmet or a mask, stocking cap, which I learned I did not know, or not stocking cap, like a baklava. Learned that I did not really know how to draw one of those on a human head until like last year. I was like, oh, that is so completely wrong looking, and I had to actually look at reference to figure out why I was screwing that up. So anyway, it makes me practice things I wouldn't normally practice. Okay. All right. New pen. Let's see what we got here. I think, where's this light source going to be? Here? Yeah, sure. All the reflective stuff. It's going to reflect. It's going to be in that thing. So, reflect short. Shoulder. And then, you know, whatever's in the distance over here. And I'm going to replicate that over here. Here's a dark blue costume. So it'll be pretty dark. Be darker than the helmet. I think it goes all the way up his neck under the helmet. And a little bit of reflective light here. Bounce light. Okay. So one thing I've learned about this new pen or brush pen is that it's pretty good for like line work. So I can draw really thin lines. But for filling in, man, just that's not what it's for. So, my other one. Which is better for filling in blacks. Let's see, this will be kind of light. There. Collarbone will have. Cast shadow. Let's see, this will be reflecting everything over here. And reflecting the helmet itself. Then the body, okay. On the collarbone. Helmet would cover this part. Lighten up over here. More helmet coverage here. A little bit of light there. Dark again. Okay. Shoulder comes in there, actually. Okay. And now, this one has a tendency to, I think the line, where is it? The tip bends ever so slightly. Probably from using it too much. Okay. Okay. Looks like the right guy. Me a moment to practice my lettering too. It's gonna be a little bit thick. Ooh, this paper's not great for lettering, despite it being made for writing on. Okay. Nova, more or less. Okay. Put him aside for the moment. All right, back to the roulette wheel, so to speak. Cut the deck. What we got? Static Shock. Okay. Just static. All right. Alright, he's got a lot of energy stuff. Which version do I want to draw of him though? There's like a million. Let's do. I guess we'll do the traditional one. Also, let me straighten this out a little. Okay. Okay, that'll work. So, now how much of him do I want to draw here? Let's go. Hairline's about there. He's young. Okay. That's the top of his head. Let's get the head shape right at least. Seems like it should be thinner than this drawing I'm looking at. I'm gonna get a different reference. I don't like this one. Let's pick the largest one. Boy, not very many of them are good, so I think I'm gonna draw him as I feel like it. I think he should be thinner. Okay. Course, he does have broad nose, so his neck's about right. Don't like that hair going way out to the side like that, so. That color's bigger than I thought it was. Holy crap. Alright. Yeah, I was right. I mean, I get a thin line with this thing. It's like a real brush. Okay, let's see if I can get the thinner face right after redrawing it. Don't think I drew enough of those lines on his lapel, but he doesn't have many. that up a little. Yeah. Part of this exercise is that I have to be fast, or at least somewhat fast, get stuff done. Because speeding things up, getting things done with a certain amount of energy, is kind of important when you're trying to keep up production schedule on a comic book. So, knowing where I should draw lines, where I should just fill in black with heavy lines. Where I should break things up with thin lines. Like that. This is one of those things that old time inkers used to do. Just lay the edge of the brush down to get a texture that they kind of wanted. Watch Walt Simon. What was it? Was it Al Williamson or Walt Simonson? Can't remember. He did a lot of Star Wars books. I think it was Walt Simonson. Got the basics. Let's see, his dread should be stacked up on other dreads, so there wouldn't be all this white space in there. Kind of a fun expression. But shadows over here. No, it covered that up, sorry. See, one of my other brushes fills more black quickly. It's a bigger brush, but oof, not great. Come on, fill. Tempted to use a Sharpie on it just to have it done. Come on. This one's a medium-sized one. Does this fill faster? This one appears to do better. This one's also pretty new. Only used it like twice. How thin a lines can I get with this one? It's pretty thin. Okay. Now I know. Okay. There's a hair on the end of this. Get off there. And once again, practicing lettering. So we can do it a little more interesting. Ooh, this is hard to do with a brush pen. I have to shift my hand angle. Okay. All right. So these are taking about 20 minutes each. Oh, you know what? I need to sign these. How do I sign this one? Okay. Oh, could do a little more rendering on this. Just a little bit. Just this spot right here. Okay. All right. I think it's going to be good for the warm up. One Marvel, one DC. All right, that'll be it for now. I'm going to do this again tomorrow. See how it goes.